Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to TechGig webinar series. Our endeavor to empower techies. We believe that sharing of knowledge is the key to enhance our skills and grow us as professionals. With this principle in mind, we have initiated a series of webinars conducted by industry experts to give you all a crisp insight of various domains. The topic of today's session is achieving CMMI the IBM rational way. Our guest speaker today is Raghu Srinivas Murthy, brand architect IBM. Raghu currently works as a IBM rational brand architect with a focus on technical pre-sales. He has 12 years of IT experience and enables customers to integrate best practices, processes, automation tools and provide mentoring services. Raghu speaks regularly at international conferences, seminars, users group sponsored by IBM. He is an IBM Rational Certified Professional. He holds a MBA in Marketing from Symbiosis University, Pune. So, without further delay, I introduce you all to our guest speaker. Over to you, Raghu.
Okay. Thank you, Aradhana. I really appreciate that. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. Let me begin this discussion by thanking all of you for joining us today. For this interesting topic, achieving CMMI IBM rational way. Okay, this is the brief agenda what we have for this discussion today. We're going to discuss about the CMMI and the process areas, the categories and the practices. And then we'll try to understand how do we automate these process areas using set of IBM rational portfolio and set of solutions. And finally, we get introduced to the IBM rational set of solutions. So this is the brief agenda what we have for next 45 to 50 minutes. Moving to next slide number three. Okay, we are in the interesting phase of software development and delivery model. We are in the era of software-driven innovation and differentiation. If you look at any of the industry verticals, defense, aerospace, electronics, retail, automobile, software is being used as a major differentiating factor compared to the competitors, and softwares are driving innovation at all walks of life, not only the industrial sector. Even if you take up the ministries of Indian government, you know, software is being automation, technology plays a very important role, key role in every aspect of life. The slide talks about two major aspects. Based on some of the statistics by Deloitte Consulting. One is the mobile banking, which in India, which we are trying to implement, making it as mainstream, is going to be the widely used banking channel by 2020. It's already a major banking channel in some of the countries like Philippines. Some of the African nations are using mobile banking in a big way. And if you look at today's automobile machines, cars manufactured by all these BMW, not only BMW, Hyundai, Maruti, they got more million lines of software compared to a fighter jet. I know that's an amazing fact, the data that we have in front of us. So, you know, these are the statistics that we have. And if you look at from a day-to-day activity, in my life and in your life, you know, if you look at today's Meru cabs, or if you look at Flipkart, e-commerce online retail portals, they are differentiating themselves by competitors using software technology as a major driving factor, major innovating factor. So software has become a driving factor for the innovation, differentiating factor from a competitive perspective, and they have become a major source of value creation for the organizations and for the businesses. Having said that, software increasingly driving the innovation. Having said that, moving to the next slide, there exists challenges in terms of successfully developing and delivering the software. What are those challenges in terms of effectively, successfully delivering the software to your clients and my clients' customers? One is, today's software has become very complex in nature. It's no more VB application, standard C++ application, correct? You have security, you have social networking, the mobility, the cloud, the legacy applications, software as a service, platform as a service, outsourcing. It's a very complex, tricky subject, and the market pressures. These are driving organizations, and these are major hurdles in terms of developing and delivering so-called successful software to end customers. Look at the complexities that are involved in terms of delivering a successful software. One is, you have a multi-platform systems and applications. You have packaged applications, mobility applications, legacy software, mainframe applications. So that's one kind of challenge that we have in terms of developing and delivering software-driven innovation to our customers. Again, you have globally distributed development team, on-site and offshore model, outsourcing strategy, outsource model. Cost reduction, that's being a mandate of COO and CEO. You have to do more with less. Increasing mandates from government organizations, from industry bodies, HIPAA compliance, SOX compliance, RBI guidelines. Changing requirements due to business, due to competition, due to regulations. Time to market has become very crucial in this agile world and mobility world. So, lots of challenges in terms of developing and delivering so-called successful software. Moving to next slide. Okay, apart from these challenges, the practical challenge in any software services organization or when developing and delivering a successful software is all these teams working in silos, they are not on the same page. Transparency is missing, collaboration, the real collaboration is not happening. So the businesses which are deciding in terms of strategy, in terms of vision, in terms of execution, and the development team which actually develops and delivers the software, and the operation team which deploys and manages the software, they are not on the same page. So the businesses, development, and operations, they are working in silos. There exists a barrier between these three different kind of teams. They're not on the same page. This is another major hurdle in terms of developing and delivering a successful software to the customers and to the enterprises. Now the question is, okay, fair enough. Where is CMMI coming into picture? We're talking about innovation, you know, using different jargons, the differentiation and value creation factor to enterprises and to the customers. Now, CMMI, capability maturity model, is one of the methodology framework for the process improvement in software engineering. The CMMI gives you the best practices. It defines certain categories. It provides around 22 process areas for software engineering and the development. Correct? Now, CMMI has introduced maturity model areas, maturity levels for services, software services, and even for the acquisition strategy, they came up with their own process areas and maturity levels. We are looking at more towards software engineering, software development today, in our discussion today, everyone. I guess it's still, you know, there is a bit latency in terms of slide display view. Aradhana, are you okay? Now I can see the 100%. Okay. Now, if you look at the CMMI categories, the entire process areas are divided into four categories: process management, project management, engineering, and support. So these are the major four categories that we have in software development or software engineering, process improvement. And it defines around 22 process areas around these four categories. And it has got maturity levels to measure the capabilities of software delivery processes of each organization. CMMI level one, initial, repeatable, managed, defined, you know, optimized. So there are different kind of maturity levels. So CMMI gives you the methodology framework and it gives you the best practices in terms of process improvement and software engineering and software delivery, correct? And then just having CMMI process there defined is not enough. You know, the process areas, the work products, work breakdown structure, the outcomes, the input, it's not enough. It becomes a, you know, a story, a static pages. How do I automate these process areas? How do I implement these process areas to make sure that I have this software driven innovation happening in my customer place or in my organization? So you need automation, correct? I'll give you a couple of facts where we can discuss. Cognizant recently means 2-3 months back, signed a infrastructure management service deal with IPsoft. IPsoft is an infrastructure automation providing company based out of US, which is managed by which was a startup and started by Indian origin person. What it's doing is it's automating most of infrastructure management calls, infrastructure management services, and they had signed up similar kind of deals with Infosys and other organizations. And CGI CEO Michael, he was in Bangalore recently, and he made a statement 1 month back, 1.5 months back. He said, we have 69,000 people and we have the same market capitalization and revenue of TCS, which is almost around 2.77 lakh people, approximate figures. This came in Times of India only. Now what we're trying to do is automation, how automation plays so important role in terms of value creation and developing and delivering the successful software. You can do more with less. Okay, that's the, you know, message that I wanted to discuss with you people. The automation, and we also discussed about the challenge in terms of bringing these businesses, development team and the operations team coming together, breaking the barriers between decision making body, development and operations people. So how do we do that? So the question is, CMMI could be one of the best methodology or framework to have, and we need automation, and we need to break the barriers between these major teams to effectively develop and deliver the software. The question is, how do we do that? So that's where IBM Rational comes into picture, IBM set of solutions and portfolio. The Rational is one of the brands within IBM, which provides application lifecycle management solutions and set of capabilities to organizations. Let's try to understand how can we achieve this CMMI, or how do we implement these CMMI process areas using IBM set of portfolio and set of solutions. That's the agenda for today. That's what we'll be